This is Jupiter. It has a huge gravitational pull on its closest moons. We're going to talk about the effects of this gravitational coupling between Jupiter and its moon Io. We'll start by talking about the tidal bulge, how the tidal bulge is formed. We'll use the Earth-Moon system as an example. When the bulge is locked in place on the moon, we call that tidal locking. And what it does is it makes the moon rotate at a constant rate as it orbits the Earth. We'll then move to talking about the Jupiter-Io-Europa system. Europa is another moon that orbits Jupiter. They have orbital resonance, which means they sync up periodically as they orbit. This syncing up of orbits means that Europa tugs Io's orbit into an elliptical shape. This elliptical orbit causes Io to move faster when it's closer to Jupiter. The combination of tidal locking and elliptical orbit produce tidal flexing. This tidal flexing produces internal heat in Io, causing volcanic eruptions to happen. There's a similar effect on Europa. And on Europa, because it has ice, it creates vast liquid oceans on Europa and the possibility for life. The moon orbits the Earth in a relatively circular orbit. So as it goes around, according to Kepler's second law, the moon sweeps out equal areas in equal times. The moon is also tidally locked to the Earth, so the same side of the moon faces the Earth at all times. The tidal locking gives the moon a tidal bulge. The bulge points toward the Earth, the same direction at all times. With the Jupiter-Io-Europa system, we have something else happening. So Jupiter here is in the center, Io is the first moon out, and Europa is the second moon out. And as Europa makes one orbit, Io orbits twice. Io moves twice as fast, so as they go around every other orbit for Io, they reach the same point in their orbits. Now what this does is it gives an orbital tug, a gravitational tug on Io every other time, which gives it an elliptical orbit as opposed to a circular orbit. And Jupiter would be found at one orbital focus of the ellipse, not in the center over here, but pushed over at an elliptical focus. This elliptical orbit has consequences for the Jupiter-Io system. According to Kepler's second law, the moon sweeps out equal areas at equal times. Right? If we show the areas, you can see that the distance the moon has moved is farther than when it was over here. The moon is moving slower when it's over on this side of the orbit and speeds up when it comes in closer. So the moon has this tidal bulge. For every point in time when the moon is moving around, the tidal bulge is always pointed toward the center object. You can see it along these lines. The tidal bulge always is oriented right along the line, no matter where the moon is in its orbit. But because they're moving at equal times and the moon rotates on its axis at a constant rate, the same side of the moon does not always align up with the line along the tidal bulge toward the planet Jupiter. This arrow represents one point on the moon's surface, so as the moon orbits around, you can see the bulge always points toward Jupiter, but the arrow doesn't always point toward Jupiter. Sometimes it leads a little bit and sometimes it lags a little bit. And because that arrow represents one position on the surface of the moon Io, what that means is that Io gets flexed back and forth and back and forth as it rotates around Jupiter. Now, we can also show this in the frame of what it would look like if you're on Io. What you'd feel was that the ground underneath you was being squished back and forth as you rotated around Jupiter. And this tidal flexing creates heating inside the moon Io. This is a photograph of Io. You can see there's volcanic activity happening all over the surface of Io, and there's even a volcano erupting that you can see the plume against the black of the space. This volcanic activity in Io is evidence that this tidal flexing causes a great deal of heat inside the moon. This is a photograph of Europa. Europa is farther away from Jupiter than Io is, and it also experiences tidal flexing. Europa also has a lot more water on it than Io does, and this water is melted and refrozen and melted and refrozen and cracked from the tidal flexing. We think there's enough heat from the tidal flexing that the water is liquefied all the way down to the core of the moon. That's why there's brown material showing up in the cracks from the ocean venting from the volcanic activity down in the core of the moon. This probably produces vast liquid oceans of water on Europa, and this is exciting because it also provides a possibility for life.